Princeton shapes plasma physics, right? And it shapes it around the world. And it shapes it through this program. It shapes it through the lab too, but this program, because a lot of the, you know, leading early career people come through our program, it makes a huge difference.
It was really clear that Princeton had like the best slew of research opportunities, from low temperature plasmas to really good theory program to, you know, experimental programs on big tokamaks, on ignition, inertial confinement fusion, running the gamut.
I looked at a potential career in fission and wasn't as interesting. I wanted to do more research. So fusion seemed to combine the best of both worlds, the possibility to really help personkind, but also to use my skills in both physics and nuclear engineering. So the Princeton program seemed like the best fit, and I made a great choice.
Partly coming to Princeton was an adventure, but also because this was the place, right, where plasma physics was almost invented in Princeton. You know, in the 1950s and 60s, they started the program with almost no understanding of plasmas. And so not only did they have to try to develop fusion, they also had to develop the field of plasma physics. And those early days and right up to the present day, some of the most fundamental things in the science of plasmas come from Princeton.
Everyone who comes out of the program knows at minimum the basics. And what is defined here as the basics is always like a little bit above what other people would maybe define as the basics. So just the overall quality and the broad knowledge that the students get coming out of this program is outstanding.
You had freedom to choose between different projects and change projects over the course of the graduate studies, and that really appealed to me as someone that came in not really knowing exactly what I wanted to do. Finding all of those options and really learning what it meant to do research in this area or this area with different people was really valuable.
The number of potential thesis advisors, supervisors, outnumbers the number of graduate students, so there are many opportunities for different projects to work on.
It has so much history. Like, we are at the very heart where some of the plasma physics great-grandfathers have worked, where they have done the first steps into plasma physics. So being in this space where we know this has happened is kind of a magical feeling.
I think we'd all like to see a bit more diversity in our program, and it's growing with time. Again, because the program shapes the field, we need to make sure our program is diverse, because otherwise the field isn't diverse, right? And so that's a challenge that I think we need to rise to.
I really like that our program is so collaborative, that we have a community here where we all support each other and we all help each other with the problem sets.
I think what might not be noticed so much is the students you're with also are really, you know, incredible people, so many of whom end up being leaders in plasma physics.
The plasma physics program is unique at Princeton, and that is that the burden of the program is only partly on people who are what we call ladder faculty at Princeton. A huge amount of the work is done by staff members from PPL who essentially give their effort to the program because they believe in it. And it's kind of beautiful.